communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words than what I have done and what I have failed to do through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who were pleased to give light to your church by the example and teaching of the bishop saints Basil and Gregory, grant, we pray, that in humility we may learn your truth and practice it faithfully in charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, who is the liar? Whoever denies that Jesus is the Christ. Whoever denies the Father and the Son, this is the Antichrist. Anyone who denies the Son does not have the Father, but whoever confesses the Son has the Father as well. Let what you heard from the beginning remain in you. If what you heard from the beginning remains in you, then you will remain in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise that he has made, eternal life. I write you these things about those who would deceive you. As for you, the anointing that you received from him remains in you, so that you do not need anyone to teach you. But this anointing teaches you about everything that is true and not false, just as it taught you, remain in him. And now, children, remain in him, so that when he appears, we may have confidence and not be put to shame by him at his coming. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness towards the house of Israel.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
All the ends of the earth have seen the saving power of God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
This was the testimony of John when the Jews from Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to him to ask him, "Who are you?" He admitted and did not deny it, but admitted, "I am not the Christ." So they asked him, "What are you then? Are you Elijah?" And he said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." So they said to him, "Who are you, so we can give an answer to those who sent us? What do you have to say for yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying in the desert, 'Make straight the way of the Lord.'" As Isaiah the prophet said, some Pharisees were also sent. They asked him, "Why then do you baptize if you are not the Christ or Elijah or the prophet? John answered them, I baptize with water, but there is one among you whom you do not recognize, the one who is coming after me, whose sandal strap I am not worthy to untie. This happened in Bethany across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I am not me. My brothers and sisters, if we know anything about the Christian life, we know that everything points to Christ and not to ourselves. It's very important that every glory and honor be devoted to Him. As we just conclude the octave of Christmas and now enjoy this beautiful time during this season of the birth of Christ, once again we come upon this beautiful feast of Gregory and Basil, the beautiful saints of the East. And we also understand in the Gospel that we all need to reflect upon the grandeur, the love of God, which has been entrusted to us to carry out to others. But in no way do we allow the light to shine to us. It must always shine for the honor and glory of God. You hear John the Baptist say that very clearly when they're questioning, who are you? Are you the Christ? Are you Elijah? Are you the prophet? Who are you? No, I'm not any of that. I'm just a voice crying out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. I baptize with water. One mightier than I, who I'm not even worthy to unfasten the straps of his sandals, he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. All during our journey of life, we as people of God always direct our attention to the Christ and point to him like John the Baptist, like Basil and Gregory, who were doctors of the church, bishops. They gave us instruction and understanding about who is the Christ, who is this person, the Godhead, the second person of the Blessed Trinity, a divine person, fully human and fully divine, and yet is the Word made flesh. It's a mystery that you and I contemplate even to this day. And we point to that light of faith, the same light in which we understand that the Magi came to find him. See, everything points to the Christ. We are to follow, we are to pay him homage, and to give him glory. May we never forget that in our own discipleship as we follow him day after day. And as we come upon this beautiful gospel of St. John the Baptist, when they're questioning him, may we always remind ourselves to point to the light. As is said in the Mass, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. No other person, no other prophet, only him, and him to be honored and glory forever. God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before practical means of St. Mary's parish, so that all of us may point to the light, Jesus Christ, who has come into this world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, which will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Grace to the brothers that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept the sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honor of Saints Basil and Gregory a means to our eternal salvation. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Basil and Gregory, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of their holy lives. Teach us by their words of preaching, and keep us safe in answer to their prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing our hymn of praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood,
the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Since I cannot at this moment
body. The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Let us pray. May partake